A seahorse, made of clockwork gears, darted out of the way as Merin approached. She wondered who could have built such a curious creature. Merin approached a glowing scrap of metal and pulled it inside. It was claw-shaped and had a strong magnetic pull. She took out her tools and attached it to a firing mechanism on her steering column. Spotted shock nettles ahead of her. She had to be cautious, as the hostile creatures would attack her on sight. Sleeping guardian blocked Merin's path. She knew it all too well from her father's stories, and she knew it must never be woken. According to her father, the Guardians had been built by ancient undersea explorers called the Fomori. Merin always thought the Fomori were a myth. Now she wondered if her father's other stories might be true. Twisted forms of sunken ships stretched out in the distance. Was her father's boat somewhere among them? Statue reminded her of her father's lullabies about the brave and beautiful Merrows. unexplored, she sketched the terrain on a sheet of cartography paper. Her father had taught her that those who make maps are never lost. A huge hermit crab watched Merin from a rocky ledge. On his back, he carried a vast array of odd-looking treasures. The crab seemed to like shiny objects. Maybe he would be willing to make a trade. Using the materials she bought from the hermit crab, Merin took out her tools and made a quick modification to her magnetic claw. Amidst the wreckage of an old Fomori vessel lay an undamaged propulsion device. Merin bolted it onto the back of her submarine, eager to test out its effects on her lightweight craft.
Thank you.
giant clams were notoriously picky eaters. Each one seemed to prefer a different kind of treat. Her. She knew this place from her father's songs. These were the lost ruins of the Merrows. Lantern jellies blocked Merrin's path. Although the creatures could be deadly to the touch, they were very shy and even avoided each other's light. Through the windows of the houses, wondering if a Merrow girl once lived there, and if her father had sung her lullabies about the world above. Discovered two glowing lights amidst the scraps of an old Fomori machine. She attached them to the front of the submarine's hull, hoping they would help guide her on her journey. Color darted through the shadows. Was that a Merrow maiden swimming through the ruins? Merrin tried to speak to her, but the Merrow raced away. Tugged at Merrin's sob. Was this a Tyne vortex? Where might it lead? At last, the Merrow Maiden stopped. Merrin called to her. "Please wait! I'm only trying to find my father." The Merrow looked at her for a long moment, then stirred the water with her hands, forming a ghostly image. It was the sunken ship graveyard known as Skeleton Reef. Could her father be trapped there? The Merrow pointed the way to go, and Merrin thanked her. Before she turned to go, Merrin asked the Merrow her name.
"Call me Kara," she said. "Another girl once called me that, years ago. She said it means friend."
Merrin picked up a fragment of a Fomori Sentinel's hull. She hammered it into the wall of her own submarine, making it more resistant to damage.
Thank you.
The seahorse was poking at a glass wall. Such a strange creature, Merin thought. She wished she could understand what it wanted. The lost graveyard of ships, Merin would have to cross the foul and treacherous region known as Watcher's Hollow. This was a place her father had never sung about, for the tales of the Watcher were known only to those below. Merin shuddered, as if recovering from a bad dream. For a moment,